My name is Erin Buchholz. I'm the Integrated Pest Management Specialist at the Minnesota Landscape Arboretum, and today I'm going to show you how to prevent the spread of jumping worms when you're trying to share plants from one place to another. That is one of the main ways that we spread jumping worms, is if we dig it out of the ground, soil and all, put it in a new place, we've taken the worms with us. So the first thing you want to do is set up your space with clean tools, and making sure you have a hose with some water handy and also a bucket with water handy. I have my trusty soil knife right here. As you can tell, I've done a pretty good job cleaning it off. You can't really see any soil on it. If there's caked on soil on your tools, make sure you clean those off in the last place that you worked. You always want to make sure you're starting off with a clean tool, because that's another way that worms can jump from one place to another, is you've got mud on here. Their cocoons look like peppercorns, except they're even smaller than that. They blend right in with the mud, and that's a way that you can spread from one area to another. So I've got a clean soil knife. I'm going to divide some of this lily of the valley and show you how to clean it off so that you can properly, safely take it from one area to another without taking the worms. All right, I have my lily of the valley right here, but I don't want to take all this soil with me, because I guarantee there are jumping worm cocoons all over this soil. If I plant it in a new place, those worms are going to hatch and they're going to invade the new garden. So the way that I can prevent that is by shaking off the soil back where I dug it out from, getting as much of it off before I get it wet as possible. So I'm shaking it off, I'm kind of tapping it against the sidewalk here to help me get as much soil off as I can. Put it right back where you found it. But you can see, even doing that, I still have soil here. And again, there's probably cocoons in there. So I have a couple options. I have a bucket of water right here. I'm dunking it in the water, I'm swishing it around for a little while, and trying to wash off as much as I can. That's better. There might still be a little bit in here, so maybe I'll have two buckets of water just to do a final rinse. But as long as I'm looking at it and I don't see anything, I've got a little bit more right here, so I'm gonna try and wash that off too. That looks a lot better. I don't really see any big chunks of soil. So that's one way to do it. But another way to do it that I think works even better is I have another one here. I already tapped as much soil as I can off, but there's still a little bit left. So if you have a garden hose handy, what you can do is go over to it. These shutoff valves that are made out of brass are my best friend, because they do a really high pressure spray. You can also attach them to any other garden hose nozzle that you want to. And it's a nice way to shut off the water when you're not actively using it. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wash off my plant in the same area here so that I'm not spreading worms from one area to another. I'm just gonna wash the soil right back into the bed. I'm gonna wash in the nooks and crannies of the plants too. So no soil is in the leaves or in the buds. And look at that, I think it's even cleaner than the bucket method. So this is my favorite one. So that's one way to clean off your plants. Make sure that you're washing inside too, because there might be some soil hidden, but usually most of it is gonna be here. Look for anything that looks like a grain of sand, and just make sure it's as clean as possible. Now your last step is always to clean off your tools before you move on to another area. Look at my trowel, my soil knife. It is just full of soil, and I guarantee it's full of jumping worm cocoons too. I don't want to take this somewhere else. So in the same area I was digging, I'm going to wash off my tool. First I can scrape it off with my hands. Get off as much soil as possible, put it right back where I was working. I'm not increasing my jumping worm numbers at all, because it's the exact same place I was working. But I still don't want to leave it like this. I want to get it clean. So with my shutoff valve, again, I'm going to wash off my tool, get off as much of the soil as I can, try and get it as clean as possible. Because remember, these cocoons are about the size, smaller than a peppercorn. They are usually only about 1 to 3 millimeters in diameter, which is pretty small, easy to miss. So I'm washing off my hands too. Get as much mud off as possible. Now, my bucket that has all this icky water in it, probably has jumping worm cocoons in it too, right? I can pour it right back to where I was digging, where I removed the plants from, because again, I am not moving worms from one area to another. I'm keeping them all in the same original spot. So I'm gonna pour out my water, and then I'm gonna rinse out my bucket right in the same spot. Wait, I'm not done yet. For any sort of plant pest issue, I like to use Lysol or the generic equivalent, because Lysol, as we learned from COVID, kills just about everything that's a problem, right? So I could still have some soil-borne fungus on my trowel. You know, even the water washed off most of it, but what if it didn't get it all? I want to disinfect my tools, and this is always good practice when moving from a place to another, even if you don't have jumping worms, because there is a lot of stuff in the soil and a lot of stuff with the plants that we work with that could transfer from one plant to another. So, after I wash it off, here is my generic Lysol. Not gonna show you the label because it's sold in under many, many different names, but pretty much every hardware store, garden center, something will have a disinfectant that's a Lysol variety. So I'm gonna just go spray off my tools completely. Within 30 seconds, it's all right. I can spray off my bucket too if I want to. I'm gonna tell you, usually I don't, but I'm just doing this for the camera. But usually getting it a thin covering of Lysol on it, it'll kill any pathogen. I don't know if it kills the cocoons or not, but it definitely makes me feel better. So always start with a sanitized tool and always end with a sanitized tool. So thank you for joining us.